From the pages of the WWF Magazine, here's Update.
Hello, everyone. I'm Gorilla Monsoon for Update. Newsflash, currently underway. In fact, it's going to start this coming Monday. A big, gigantic women's tournament being held in Memphis, Tennessee. It will conclude next Monday. It will decide who will be the next reigning World Wrestling Federation ladies champion. We're going to be bringing you all that data, footage, and everything, and tell you who won and everything else on all the WWF programs. So keep abreast of that. But I want to talk a little bit right now about the past 1993 blockbuster WWF Survivor Series. What a night it was in the Boston Garden. All kinds of action, all kinds of excitement. Big matches between the All-Americans, the Foreign Fanatics. How about that confrontation between The Undertaker and the big 600-pound-plus WWF champion, Yokozuna? But you know the thing that stuck out in my mind most of all in the Survivor Series, and a lot of murmurings here in the World Wrestling Federation, the Family Feud match. There seemed to be a little dissension in the ranks of the Hart family. We're going to try to clear that all up here this week on Update, because waiting on the phone right now, we've got on hold, me, you know, calling the event at ringside, there was a little bit of dissension in the ranks, Owen. It was like only a few pancakes left at the breakfast table, and who was going to get them?
Well, I'm just a little fed up. That's just another example of what happens. And with me and Brett being in the ring together, it kind of came out there. And all I want is an opportunity to do my own, show my own ability in the ring, and I believe that I can prove I'm equally as good as Brett. Just give me a chance.
You know, Owen, I'm sure it just wasn't myself, but everybody that thought about the Family Feud match thought that there would be a whole lot more out of you guys, being brothers, you know, being that close, that, well, it just wasn't there.
Well, I kind of expect a little more leadership out of Brett, and you know, he was kind of the leader of the group, and he didn't really lead us. He kind of led us astray, and really it wasn't my fault. I don't want to be pointing fingers, but...
But you are pointing fingers.
Well, you got to point at who's ever the leader of the team, and in my opinion, that was Brett.
You're saying that the Hitman didn't carry his share of the load?
Well, I don't think he did.
You don't think he did? Well, Owen, I appreciate your calling and appreciate talking with you, and I wish you continued success here in the World Wrestling Federation, and say hello to Stu for me, please.
Thank you very much, Gorilla.
Thank you, Owen. Well, we're going to get to the bottom of that, folks. I'm sure we haven't heard the last of the confrontation between the Harts. In fact, you know, as I viewed it, the action was so fast and furious throughout the whole event that it's hard to pick out one specific incident. Well, we're going to get a chance to, everybody's going to get a chance to see it again. And if you didn't see it the first time, here's your chance to see it for the first time. The encore performance will be this Tuesday at 8 p.m., 8 Eastern and 8 Pacific, so pick up your phone, call your local cable company, take advantage of this chance, and if you did see it the first time, here's another opportunity to go back and take a look. Focus in on the Family Feud match. Focus in on the Harts. What exactly were they doing? Were they cohesive as a team? Whose fault was it? Well, we're going to answer all those questions in the weeks to come here in the World Wrestling Federation. For Update, this has been Gorilla Monsoon.
Now let's go face to face, ladies and gentlemen. We have the incomparable Brett the Hitman Hart, along with Harvey Whippleman, the manager of Atom Bomb. And Harvey, I understand that you requested this time, and we're certainly always happy to talk to you, Harv. I will mention that. But what's on your mind here this week?
Well, Jim Ross, I greatly appreciate you allowing me to have this time so I can confront Brett the Hitman Hart. Brett, ever since I've taken over the management of the great force, Atom Bomb, I've done everything within my power to take him all the way to the top in the World Wrestling Federation. And the only way to get all the way to the top is to beat all the top contenders, all the top athletes, and all the top wrestlers. And you, Bret Hart, are the only one that's been ducking away from Atom Bomb. You're the only one that's scared.
Oh, Harvey, that's not true, and you know it, Harv.
Well, Atom Bomb has got something to say to Bret Hart right now, and we'll see if it's true or not.
Bret Hart, I openly challenge you to one-on-one, because when you step in the ring with Atom Bomb, annihilation is inevitable.
What do you say, Bret, huh?
You want a match? Big boy, you want a match? You got a match. You want to earn a reputation? You got your chance. Harvey Whippleman, you little shrimp, why don't you shut your face, for starters? Now, I know you're undefeated, Atom Bomb. And I know that you think, oh, you're going to build some kind of a reputation by using me as a platform, that you're going to wipe me out, and that you're going to go further on. Well, I got news for you. It's not going to happen. You're talking about technical wrestling. They call me the best there is, the best there was, and the best there ever will be. And Atom Bomb, I got news for you. You are just going to be that,
a big, giant bomb.
Be getting the bigger trophy next year.
All right, Hitman! What an ovation for the Hitman, huh?
Yeah, if I'd have won it, their ears would have been bleeding.
Brett, congratulations to you. A very prestigious award.
You know, I had a big flowery speech I was going to recite out here, but I think I'm going to come straight from the heart.
Wow.
One of the most important things in my life has been knowing that the fans have never, you fans out there, have never, ever stopped believing in me. And it's a great feeling to know that you fans have just never, you never seem to give up on me, do you?
It's another male action
moment.
And I must
say, you don't give up on them, Brett.
Well, it's a great feeling, and I know there's a lot of rising young stars on the horizon, and I know that there's a lot of people that you could have voted for, and at a time this time in my career, you know, when it's easy to stop believing in yourself, it's a great feeling to know that all you fans that voted for me still believe in me.
Yeah, I believe
it's
in
made
Santa.
Me realize that there is still a lot of things left for me to achieve in the World Wrestling Federation. I want to make one promise to the absolute best of my ability. I promise I'm going to do every single thing in my power to win back the World Wrestling Federation Championship belt for you people that voted for me. When I think of this trophy,
he thinks of a pawn shop.
You know, I want to thank, actually, what I'd like to do is I'd like to dedicate this trophy to all those fans that year in and year out that never, ever gave up on me.
Well, these two people got to share the trophy.
I want to dedicate this trophy to you people. I want to dedicate this award to my friends that have stood by me. I want to dedicate this trophy especially to my family, my mother, my father, all my brothers, my sisters, my wife, my four kids at home that have all stood through the thick and the thin, the good and the bad, that have always, always taught me to stay cool, to live long, live strong, and to never hope against hope. I dedicate this award to you. Thank you very, very much.
All right, the Hitman, Bret Hart.
Owen Hart does have quite a big proboscis.
I'm referring, yes, to Owen Hart. He does not. And again, some of the fans chanting, "We want Bret." And Duffy.
Ooh, oh, goodness, did you hear that?
Wow.
I need to see it. Owen.
But I didn't feel it.
Leveling Duffy, and Duffy has no idea where he is.
Of course not.
My goodness.
I bet that was a long, cold trip home to Calgary.
Look at that from the Tyler Walk at that. Unbelievable. Owen Hart with a maneuver that I must say that would emulate that of his brother, Brett, a moment ago, now to the top rope. Owen Hart, drop kick from the top. Nicely done. Take nothing away. No one can take anything away from Owen Hart.
This is unusual. He's going for the sharpshooter.
Wait a minute, he certainly is.
He came out wearing his glasses.
And an easy victory for Owen Hart over Chris Duffy.
Owen Hart has not given an interview to anyone. Not Dan Rather, not Peter Jennings, not Larry King. I'm going to get an interview with him right now. You want the job done right? I'll do it.
I'd like to see this. And we certainly would like to get Owen's reaction to his brother becoming the WWF Superstar of the Year. As well as
I'm going to be getting a word with Owen Hart here soon as he steps out of the ring.
So what happened?
Oh, my God, he's safe.
Well, let's see if Bobby Heenan can come through.
I'd like to ask you a question.
What was going through your mind a minute ago when you saw your brother awarded that trophy? Owen, okay, what happened to Survivor Series in front of your parents? Stu and Helen, what happened there?
is unsuccessful. Please. We'll be back with more.
Here's Update.
Hello, everyone. I'm Gorilla Monsoon for Update. Well, the big one is all over. The blockbuster, the 1993 WWF Survivor Series, is history, as well as the encore performance. And what an encore that was. A chance for everyone out there who didn't have an opportunity on Thanksgiving Eve to see the WWF Survivor Series to take advantage and see it once again. Or, you know, I could have watched it 10 times and probably still would have been things left out in my mind as far as what went down, especially in the Family Feud match. You know, everyone expected sparks to be flying. Well, they were flying, but they were flying amongst the brothers in the Hart family, between Owen and between his brother Brett. Who could have anticipated that? Well, I have my opinion on what went wrong in that match, and I'm sure those of you who saw it first time around or second time around have their own opinions, but have it, folks. You looked at it again, I looked at it again, everybody's looked at it again. I'm sure some people will be looking at it 100 times more. But I formulated my opinion, I'm sure you formulated yours, but there's only two opinions that really count. That of the Rocket Owen Hart, and that of the excellence of execution Bret the Hitman Hart. In fact, we have Cain and Abel standing by. Let's get their insights.
It was a family feud, but it wasn't supposed to be. The family against me. Well, I'm sick and tired of carrying the load of this family and never getting any recognition. It's always you, Bret. Well, I'm not carrying the load anymore. I carried the load at the Survivor Series. I had two down, and I was going for number three. When you, Brett, poor Brett, he fell off the ring apron, and the whole family, they flocked to you, Brett, and they left me all alone. Well, I got pinned, and I got eliminated. I was out of the Survivor Series. And then you have a victory celebration after you won the Survivor Series match, and you left me all alone. You didn't care to think about inviting me back. Well, that's okay. I know where I stand with the family. Obviously, you don't care about me. But you, Brett, you've been a problem for a long time for me. And you stay out of my way because I'm looking out for number one.
Oh, and this is your brother Brett talking, and we gotta talk. You know, you gotta put this behind you. I know you got a bad temper. You're upset because you got the, you know, you were the only one that lost in this thing. That is not important. Think about it. You know, the whole family worked great in there as a family, and everyone's proud of each other, and we're especially proud of you. You did great. And you can't let this thing get to you like that. I know you got a bad temper, but you got to put this thing behind you. The rest of the family's all up in arms about this thing. Owen, listen to me. This is your brother. I'm going to ask you one thing. You're going to sit down with me, Mom, Dad, and we're going to settle this thing, get it all worked out. Everything's got to be fine. This is family.
Polo, Centeno. Look at that. Shoved so hard, he went right into the second rope.
And a knee went up.
Big laugh there on the part of Jacques. Boy, everyone laughing around here. Yeah, Bobby Heenan's having a big laugh.
Well, it's fun to watch.
Yeah. And thus far here on Monday Night Raw, those who are laughing, Shawn Michaels, Diesel, along with Quebecers, Bobby the Brain Heenan.
Well, I don't think Razor Ramon's laughing.
No, I'm
he's
sure
probably
he's not.
Telling the doctor right now, I do not know, amigo, how I got the eggs on my head. Mm-hmm. You messed with the Intercontinental Champions, how you got it.
Centeno set up now, and pile driver. Nicely executed by Jacques de Quebecer as he sets him up, and here comes the tag.
Uh-oh,
here we go. We've seen this before. This is a very devastating maneuver. From the top now, it's Pierre. Pierre with the lunge and down.
Oh!
Across the chest of Centeno. Oh, my. The
one,
cover, the count.
Two and three.
Uh-huh. And Johnny Polo can finish reading his Palm Beach magazine and get back into the ring and celebrate with the Quebecers. And Walsh coming over to help his partner. Uh-oh, look at this. Walsh over the top to the outside. And what are they doing?
They're taking a load off. Relax, enjoy yourself. Matter of fact, get out of my chair.
Oh, no, give me a break.
The Pierre, Jacques and Pierre do that at picnics all the time.
Standing by, ladies and gentlemen, will be Owen Hart with some commentary as relates to the Survivor Series. However, speaking of pay-per-view events in the WWF, from Providence, Rhode Island, already sold out. It is going to be an extraordinary event, ladies and gentlemen. Speaking of extraordinary events, that would lead us to the events of last week. Bret Hart named the 1993 WWF Superstar of the Year. And with that in mind, Bobby Heenan unable to get comments last week. I believe standing by there we have the Rocket, Owen Hart. Rocket, can you hear us?
Yes, I can.
Perhaps we could get your commentary as it relates to your brother winning that most prestigious award last week.
Well, you know, Vince, that's really great for Brett. Everything's been great for Brett. But what about me? I'm the guy that stood beside him through thick and thin. And that's really great. He got an award for being the most outstanding superstar in the WWF. That's a big surprise. But you know what? I got an even bigger surprise for everybody out there, you watching Mr. McMahon and everybody else watching. I have a surprise that's gonna make everybody talk about me. That's right, the Rocket Owen Hart.
All right, well, thank you very much for joining us. Owen Hart, ladies and gentlemen, with his own surprise apparently coming up very soon. Bobby Heenan, your reaction.
I can't wait to see that. You know, Brett has always overshadowed Owen. Brett has always pushed himself in front of Owen. He's always made sure that he was in the line. I mean, the man was Intercontinental Champion, I don't know how many times, Tag Team Champion, I don't know how many times, WWF Champion, King of the Ring. And I mean, he's won everything except a washer and dryer here.
No question about that.
I know that Rick and Scott Steiner know exactly who the Quebecers are. They told me they hope those belts stay shiny because, Vince, they want to put them around their waist.
Look at this, going up to the top now. We've only seen this from Jacques and Pierre, the Quebecers. A devastating maneuver, if in fact there is impact in there.
There is. What impact? To the best of my knowledge, no man has ever kicked out of that maneuver, Vince.
No, not likely, and an easy three count here. Unfortunately for Chaz Ware, his tag team partner, Paul Jones, did not even have an opportunity to get into the match. And there you see the embrace on the part of the Quebecers. And, the fans don't like the Quebecers. They certainly do not like. Wait a minute. Wait a minute.
I don't think they're through yet.
What is this now? The announcement of the victory of the Quebecers. However, Paul Jones across the back of Jacques down to the canvas.
Obviously,
into the
referee.
Boston Crab. Look at this.
Oh, my goodness. The referee should step in right here, Vince.
From the top and down. What poor sports on the part of the Quebecers. They were embarrassed earlier on the outset of the matchup, and I guess maybe they are attempting to pay back their opposition, Chaz Ware and Paul Jones.
Both men totally incapacitated right here. This could be very, very serious.
Both men certainly humiliated, and that's exactly what the Quebecers want to do. And oh, no, look at this. Talk about humiliation. As if they are the tag team champions. Well, speaking of champions, let's take you now to the update. We'll find out exactly how Yokozuna will defend the WWF Championship and against whom at the WWF Royal Rumble.
This holiday season, just remember these careful words of wisdom. You're gonna have a good time. You're gonna be partying and you're gonna be celebrating, but don't ever forget for one second that you can't make that one big deadly mistake. Just remember one thing, don't drink and drive.
Owen, let's start with the Survivor Series. Let's start with the Hart family victory in the Boston Garden at Survivor Series, the family feud matchup. And there are those, however, who, well, I won't refer to a family feud as it relates to you and Brett, but there is some obvious friction that we saw at the Survivor Series between you and Brett during that match. And I wonder if you would elaborate on the Survivor Series.
Well, you mentioned that friction starting at the Survivor Series. That friction started a lot sooner than the Survivor Series. It started all my life. All I ever heard about was what Brett achieved. My family, my friends, they always talked about what Brett did. Well, I went out and I achieved a lot of things in my lifetime too, Vince. I was a better football player than Brett. I was a better amateur wrestler than Brett. I had better academic grades than Brett. But all the accolades went towards you, Brett. And that's fine, but it's time for me, the Rocket, to start showing everybody, not just my family, not just my friends, everybody, the wrestlers, that I, Owen Hart, can make a name for myself without using you, Brett, to launch my career.
All right, but in terms of this friction, which, as you say, started long before the Survivor Series, let's go back to the Survivor Series. You and Brett, obviously carrying the family honor in Survivor Series, but with all due respect, Owen, I would like to remind you that you were the only family member eliminated.
Well, first of all, you said me and Brett carried the family honor. To be honest, I think I carried the family honor a lot further than you did, Brett. I went out there and I beat two guys, Vince. I was on a roll and I was going for number three. Brett was stumbling around ringside. I'm going off the ropes against Shawn Michaels and I collided. Bam, right into you, Brett. A veteran of the ring, someone who ought to know to stay out of the way when the action is going on in the ring. I turn around and look at Brett. I see my brothers, Bruce and Keith. They're down at his side, they're worrying about him. He's not even in the ring. I'm the guy in the ring. And what happens? Shawn Michaels rolls me up and pins me. I'm out of it. I'm eliminated out of the Survivor Series.
Biggest match of my life. I got my family there. I got my friends, everybody watching. And I look and I see everybody looking at poor Brett. And I'm the guy that got pinned. So I go back to the locker room. I'm all alone. And I see Bruce, Brett, and Keith all celebrating to Brett's music. And I'm out there all alone. They don't invite me back to ringside. They don't bring me back to celebrate with them. So I had to go down to the ringside. And I got in the ring and I grabbed Brett. And I had to confront him face to face to let him know, quit being so selfish. All the favoritism towards you, Brett. What about me? A guy that's been in there breaking my back, carrying the family load. And you're in there getting all the recognition. I've had it up to here, Vince. I'm sick and tired of it. I'm sick and tired of hearing about what Brett's done. What about me? I've done a lot of things in my lifetime, and it's time for people to start realizing what The Rocket has done.
But Owen, you are Brett's brother.
No, wait a minute here, Vince. Brett is my brother. I am not Brett's brother. He is my brother, brother of The Rocket, Owen Hart.
All right. But Bret Hart, the 1993 WWF Superstar of the Year, former World Wrestling Federation champion, former tag team champion, former Intercontinental champion, accolade after accolade, many justifiably, and without making you angry, feel that you're living in
Go on, Vince.
How do I say it delicately?
The shadow. Go on, say it. The shadow.
We're live, and the Brooklyn Brawler now ready to lock up with the Hitman, Bret Hart.
I suppose you're taking Bret Hart's sadness thing anyway.
I'm not taking anyone's side.
You always take sides, Vince.
Wait a minute. You're the one that's biased here. You're the one that's prejudiced. Look at this. Over the head. Nicely done by the Hitman.
I'm just presenting an alternative viewpoint because nobody else will. I'm
very alternate.
That Owen Hart is trying to be a professional about this. He wants to see who the better wrestler is. He doesn't care whether it's a member of his family or not. He's not letting family get in the way. Bret Hart's the one whining about family. Helen Hart, Stu Hart, all those people, they're whining about family.
Well, hopefully we'll get an interview with the Hitman Bret Hart and get his views.
Don't you want to know who the better man is?
I'm sure it'd be a great match. But at the same time, I just can't imagine Owen challenging Bret like that. I mean, Owen has really a chip on his shoulder as far as I'm concerned. I think it was pretty obvious, wasn't it?
No, I think it was obvious that Owen is tired of having everybody talk about Bret all the time.
One, two, and can't get the leg.
Owen's just trying to prove who's best. The only way you can do that's in the ring.
I think someone has been whispering in Owen's ear. I think the Rocket has gotten some bad advice from somebody down the line. And I wonder whether or not it's you, Jim Cornette.
I haven't spoken to him lately. But I'll tell you one thing right now. If he did need some advice, I'd be more than... Because I see a lot of potential in that boy. Maybe he should give me a call. Can I leave my number with you? You wouldn't give it to him anyway.
Hopefully, Owen Hart is not listening to the likes of you.
Owen, call me.
Please.
I could help him. I'm just kidding.
Yeah, I'm sure you can.
Advice.
Next week, nice slap. Look at this. The Hitman hanging on. Next week, joining us in the broadcast booth, none other than former Intercontinental Champion Shawn Michaels. And I'm sure a whole lot to say.
Oh, I tell you, I'm going to be sure to watch that program because I love Shawn Michaels. Great. Got a lot of great opinions. Talked to him several times over coffee.
You drink coffee?
Well, no, he was drinking coffee, actually. I was drinking milk.
I see. No caffeine in your veins.
Oh, no caffeine. You know, they say it makes me hyper.
Yeah, you're a morning person for sure. To the buckle and the Brooklyn Brawler now.
Well, they say the early bird gets the worm, but you know what? I never was into worms, so I generally get up about noon.
Just there, huh?
I had worms once when I was a kid. They said it's something I played with outside in the yard.
The Brooklyn Brawler with his foot on the kisser there. And, well, I didn't understand the analogy you were trying to make earlier on before the broadcast about the Brooklyn Brawler. He, in no way does he resemble Rush Limbaugh. I don't believe at all.
No, he doesn't. I was saying that Brooklyn Brawler is much like Rush Limbaugh because, you know, the WWF Hall of Fame is coming up, and I know that Brooklyn Brawler will be inducted just like Rush Limbaugh was inducted into the Radio Hall of Fame.
And they're going to Hitman, Bret Hart, who's unquestionably a future Hall of Famer with Brawler. A nice slam from the top.
I'll tell you one thing, if you give the induction speech, I don't want you to do to him what Sally Jesse Raphael did to Rush.
The Hitman, Bret Hart, in control. The Brawler is up in the air and down to the canvas once again. I'm sure that the entire Hart family very upset during this holiday season that Owen would have the audacity to challenge.
They got to be happy about it.
Oh, please, come on. How can you possibly be happy about something like that?
How many sons they got, 16? Can you think about the shopping, the expense, just making the list alone? They don't have to buy one son a Christmas present. Just knocking one off the list would make them all happy.
The Hitman, Bret Hart, the excellence of execution, and he is really going to work on the Brooklyn Brawler. And yeah! Oh, my, what impact. You can mix it up any style you want to with the Hitman. Technically, he is superb. A cover here, and surprised that the Hitman didn't grab the leg.
Don't you think that Owen has youth on his side? I know Bret's got more experience, but Owen has the desire. He's got that fire still burning in his heart.
Wait a minute. No one is taking anything away from Owen Hart as far as his credentials are concerned. Well, he's a tremendous wrestler.
Well, maybe you should have said that a little more often before, and he would feel like he'd been appreciated, because now it's too late.
Wait a minute. Here we go. The sharpshooter in. Yes, the Hitman Bret Hart applying the sharpshooter brawler, trying to hang on and can't quite do it. The Hitman, Bret Hart, victorious once again,
but the
returning
guy,
to Monday Night Raw.
The guy can't get along with anybody, though. You know, he doesn't have any friends. All those people that cheered for him, they're just acquaintances.
The Hitman.
Recorded earlier this week with the one and only Hitman, Bret Hart.
Bret, how did it make you feel hearing your brother challenge you for a match?
Well, I'll tell you, you know, I think Owen's a pretty mixed up kid right now. And I think it's, all I can tell you is that this is something that it's gonna tear up the whole family. Worse than Owen's, I don't know where Owen gets this impression of when we grew up, of that I was always favored and he was always like off to the side. I don't remember it that way, and I really don't want to get into a big argument about it.
Was he a better athlete? Was he a better student?
Yeah, I mean, is it really important? I'm not gonna bring out the old report cards, and I mean, Owen was a great amateur wrestler. He won the provincial wrestling championships and things like that, just like I did. He followed right behind me, and I never ever felt that we needed to be compared against each other. I mean, I think what we always tried to prove and we did was that the Hart name always came to the top. And as far as this impression that Owen's living in my shadow, I don't buy that at all. Owen's never had to live in my shadow. I came a little bit before Owen to the World Wrestling Federation. I started out here before Owen, and I went on to achieve a number of successes, and all of these things, I'm proud of everything I ever accomplished in the World Wrestling Federation. I am really proud of all those things, as I think my whole family is, and Owen should be. There were never things that hurdles for him to try to get over too. There were just things, goals maybe for him to set for himself, and Owen's, he's got his whole career ahead of him.
Yeah. But at the same time, Owen feels as though he has been denied that opportunity because he is, he's your brother, although he made it very clear that he wants it to be known the other way around. You are his brother. That seems to mean a great deal to Owen. And let's go back to the Survivor Series, Bret. Let's go back to Owen's comments about you and Keith and Bruce, the three of you, celebrating in the ring, and you didn't even invite him into the ring to celebrate.
So that's not true at all. My father, Stu, told everybody, he said, when this thing's over, we're all going to go back and we're going to be in the ring, provided we won, and we're all confident we were going to win. And Owen knew very well that he was to come back to the ring with the rest of the family if something of that nature happened, or Keith, or Bruce, or even myself. We were, I was shocked at Owen, taking it that way. And
at the same time, it seems to me that I don't know if you'd call this a legitimate gripe or just what, but with all of your accomplishments, Bret, and you so humbly put things in perspective, but look at it. Tag team champion, intercontinental champion, WWF champion, just recently the superstar of the year. If you're Owen, don't you think Owen might be feeling a little jealous? Don't you think that some words of kindness from you to Owen are warranted, that, hey, you know, this is for all of us, or do you not feel that way? Are you selfish, as Owen Hart, your brother, says you are?
That's a almost a hurting question. I believe in my heart that I've never been selfish, and I've always tried to be the best big brother I could to Owen. And if somehow he's taken that I've been selfish, and then I would rather talk about it than, I mean, what is this gonna prove?
All right, but wait a minute. You know, he feels as though he has been living in the shadow. And a lot of people also feel that, given your accomplishments.
We are back. Vince McMahon and Shawn Michaels, the former Intercontinental Champion. Take a look at you live at The Rock, at the man who had the audacity to challenge his brother, Bret Hart, to a one-on-one matchup.
First of all, you've got the undisputed Intercontinental Champion here with you. But I got news for you. Bret Hart must be afraid to wrestle his brother. I think he's afraid that Owen will show everybody that he's got just as much ability as Bret the Hitman Hart does.
And in fact, he might. But it's a matchup I would suggest we will never see, because the Hitman, under no circumstances, as you heard, would face his brother, the Rocket, one-on-one. Although, you know what? We will see them, perhaps, depending upon the luck of the draw, we will see them perhaps clash during the Royal Rumble. It's every man for himself.
That's right, and maybe then we might get a chance to see just which Hart is better. Because I tell you what, Owen looks great these days.
He does indeed. I'll have to agree with that. Owen now against Mike Bell. Owen, quick go behind. Mike Bell looking for maybe a high ride. No, nice reverse. Owen, pretty much out of the same mold as the Hitman Bret Hart as far as scientific wrestling skill and knowledge is concerned. Look at that nice reversal. Very fluid. Made it look pretty easy, I would suggest.
Well, sure, and plus, you know what? Owen Hart has an added advantage. He's an aerial expert. I'm telling you, nobody, with the exception of Shawn Michaels, is better in the aerial field than the Rocket Owen Hart.
The Rocket Owen Hart in a bit of a test of strength there on the part of Mike Bell, may have yanked the hair. I'm not too sure. Count up two now. Look at that. Bridge nicely done. Oh, my. That takes awesome power and athletic prowess. Look at that. Whoa, what a maneuver. See, a head scissor almost into a DDT. Bell landing right on the top of his head.
Now, I bet you'll never see Bret the Hitman Hart do a move like that, because he doesn't have the ability to do a move like that.
I don't know if he has the ability or not. Maybe not the knowledge. I don't know. There are some differences in the style of Owen and the Hitman Bret Hart, and it's really unfortunate that during the holidays especially that there is dissension with any particular family, although I am told the Hitman Bret Hart has not given up attempting to talk some sense, if you would, into his brother Owen.
Well, sure, but I bet you for a fact that Bret the Hitman Hart gets more presents than Owen does on Christmas morning. Owen probably gets a sock full of coal or something like that.
Oh, look at this! And a part of the Rocket Owen Hart. Are you saying that the Hitman is a family favorite?
Well, I got news for you. I wrestled them all at Survivor Series.
Oh.
Bret gets a little nick, and what happens? Everybody goes crazy. Poor Owen's in the ring fighting for his life, but everybody's more concerned with Bret. What's that tell you?
Oh, my! I don't believe there's any favoritism at all. Then again, Owen would perhaps know best as far as that's concerned. Gut-rich suplex coming at you. And Bell, who facially resembles the Hitman of it. I'm sure that's just a coincidence nonetheless. Oh, Owen is all over Mike Bell. Mike Bell is outclassed in the ring as most anyone would be against the Rock. Oh, look at that now. Here we go. Mike Bell cranking it up. Mike Bell with that tremendous clothesline a moment ago. Now being more aggressive. Knee to the midsection. Nicely done by Bell. Mike Bell coming up, drops the elbow. Mike Bell for the cover.
Well, he's not going to pin Owen Hart without hooking the leg, at least.
And Owen right back down. What's this? Owen, snap suplex. By the way, right here on USA, Thursday night, a preacher-turned-gambler finds that some games are dead serious. Powers Booth stars in Wild Card. It's a USA World Premiere movie encore, Thursday night at 9, 8 Central. Mike Bell for the ride. Owen, whoa, nicely done. And again, we are seeing so many moves here on the part of Owen Hart. Uh-oh. We've seen this one before. Mostly from the Hitman, Bret Hart, the sharpshooter applied. Mike Bell trying to hang on, and he can't quite do it.
Now, see, there you go. There's a perfect example.
Here is your
Owen Hart can do anything Bret Hart can do, and I'm willing to bet he can do it better. Better.
However, you're saying that Bret can't do what Owen does, right?
See, now, Vin Man, now you're catching on. You understand what I'm talking about.
I see. And making reference to that, ladies and gentlemen, scheduled to join us momentarily, Owen Hart, the Rocket, as well as the Hitman. There they are. All right, take a look, if you would, at the smiling kissers on these two. Owen and Brett once again united and now headed to the Royal Rumble as a tag team unit to square off against the Quebecers. You guys could be tag team champions in 1994. Now that you've resolved your differences, there's no telling to what heights the Hart family can ascend.
Lex Luger, right here next week. Revenge is on our minds.
Lex Luger, we've been waiting for this for a long time.
We're coming prepared this time, and what you did to Pierre, you're not gonna do to me. You'll see. You just wait and see.
Tonight here on Monday Night Raw, let us move to yet another title match scheduled for the WWF Royal Rumble, the Tag Championship. The Quebecers fend off the challengers, the Hart Brothers, and it looks as if Brett and Owen have finally mended those fences for the holidays.
You know, a lot of things have happened the last couple weeks with the Hart Brothers, but you know, the damage is done and it's over and it's water under the bridge, and the Hart Brothers are completely in focus. And that means that the Royal Rumble, the Quebecers, you're looking at the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team belts for the last time, because we're going to be the champions after the Royal Rumble. Right, Owen?
That's right, Brett. You know, we're like a fine-tuned machine. We ironed out all the bugs. There's no problem between me and Brett, and we're focused for one thing. Royal Rumble, WWF Tag Team belts on the line. We're taking them away.
Obviously, this has to be an exciting time in the life of Owen Hart. He is looking for his first ever title shot in the World Wrestling Federation.
What annoying music that is.
Well, Jacques, ready for him to cut the music. What's going on here?
Now, I just want to settle something once and for all. Now, you know, Lex Luger, we all know it's a known fact that you have a steel plate in your arm.
We all know that.
And we also know that you knocked out my partner, Pierre, and kept him from...
Fans like that piece of news.
Well, I'm glad you're enjoying this, because I got some news for you. You also kept my partner Pierre from going to Survivor Series.
How long is it going to take to get to the news?
Well, once again, I'm glad you enjoyed that too, because I got some news for you and Lex Luger. We have made a formal plaint to Jack Tunney, and we have talked. And if all the wrestlers in the World Wrestling Federation want to do what I'm fixing to do, we're going to settle Lex Luger's problem once and for all. And you know what that is?
He may eventually make his point.
I'm very sorry, ladies and gentlemen, but I am not wrestling Lex Luger tonight until I see a doctor's paper that showed that that steel plate was put out of his arm.
Why, you ingrate.
What's he gonna do, boycott, go on strike?
You moron.
I thought we were gonna have a match here. Now, what's going on? Lex Luger's steel plate in his right arm. They're surgically implanted.
Everybody does it. Oh, what's...
Gorilla, I'm a little confused.
What a gutless wonder.
Well, we think we're going to have a match here, ladies and gentlemen. The officials are here with Jacques and Polo. We'll be right back with whatever happens.
Drop.
Well, that'll stop you in a hurry. A veteran move by one half of the WWF Tag Team Champions.
Another reversal here and reversed once again. Oh, no. Referee down. Maybe out.
Jacques ran right into Luger. And now Luger, there's a referee. He's out of it. And Polo tripped Luger. Luger was setting Jacques up for that forearm smash.
Get him.
Polo trips Luger. And now Jacques can regain the advantage, perhaps.
Lex took one heck of a header there down into the canvas.
Oh, both men colliding.
Head to head.
I'll tell you, we know that Jacques and Pierre, the Quebecers, have been avoiding the Steiner brothers like the plague. But I'm sure that Jacques' mind is far, far from tag team action now. The referee, Lex Luger, and Jacques are all down, and look who's coming.
Oh, wait a minute.
It's Pierre. Pierre coming to the ring here.
Saying something. Unfortunately, it's in French. We can't pick it up.
Pierre drops a leg on Luger. Polo has pulled Jacques out of the ring. Here comes Polo. Polo trying to get the referee alert.
Look at Pierre. He's trying to disguise himself as Jacques here and make the referee bite us.
Oh, that's a big highway robbery. And he kicked out. Luger kicked out. And Pierre can't believe it. Luger kicked out. And Pierre, those clubby blows from the 300-pounder. Luger keeps getting up. Look at the fight. And look at the courage. And Lex Luger.
And the referee still doesn't realize that it's Pierre and not Jacques inside.
Luger, Irish whips in the ropes. He missed the clothesline. Oh, Luger.
Oh, there's an elbow.
Right hands by Luger. Pierre is reeling. Luger elevates. Planet four. Luger.
He's going to use it, and I don't blame him.
Boom. He knocks out Pierre for the second time. He's going to cover it, and the referee's going to count him out.
But Pierre is not the legal guy in this match.
It's Jacques, the legal man. Jacques back in the ring. Maybe the referee just realizes now that he's counted out the wrong man. Luger with more. Luger has been dominant here.
He
knocked another one out. That's two of them. It's over.
Well, now it doesn't matter. He beat them both.
Luger has beat the WWE Tag Team Champions with that loaded forearm. And he may beat Polo as well.
Polo, yeah, I hope so.
Polo is begging. He is begging for mercy. Listen to this capacity crowd.
Give it to him, Lex.
Luger sending Polo for the ride. And boom! He brings them to their feet. Luger knocks out Polo. Luger has beat the WWF Tag Team Champions and their manager,
Lex Luger.
I must say we all will look forward to Sparky Thurman Plug headed to the WWF. He'll be racing around the square circle. How about this? What a Christmas present last week to the whole Hart family. And I can tell you, up in Calgary, they really had a great Christmas, Dan.
That is a nice sight, but I must say, I hate to play the devil's advocate, but I would have liked to see these guys, not in a fight, mind you, but in a scientific wrestling match. I would have loved to see the Hart brothers lock it up.
Well, they are. You're not going to see that, although you might see some of it in the Royal Rumble, come to think of it, because both individuals are scheduled to appear in the Royal Rumble, and it is every man for himself in the Rumble. However, as everyone knows, they will be together, and that means he's happy that they will be, competing against the Quebecers for the Tag Team Championship this year. How about that? Right around the corner, the Royal Rumble. Providence, Rhode Island, the Civic Center, the setting. The event sold out. Has been for a long, long time, and the Hitman looking on, watching his younger brother Owen, the standing side headlock on Barry Hardy. Hardy, well-seasoned veteran, and Owen now being set up, coming off, and Owen with a nice tackle. Owen over Hardy, right back now. Hardy, hip toss, no, nice reversal. Nicely done. Owen, arm drag takedown. As far as execution is concerned, Owen and the Hitman Bret Hart are par excellence. We spoke to him earlier on about teaming up together in the Royal Rumble.
Quebecers, come Royal Rumble. My brother Bret and myself, we're coming for the tag team belts. Bret's been on that mountain before, and we're coming again, ain't Bret?
That's right. The Hart brothers are in focus, and I got one thing to say to the Quebecers. At the Royal Rumble, you're going to find out the hard way that the Hart brothers mean business.
The Rocket and the Hitman obviously looking forward to teaming up at the Royal Rumble.
Did you notice, Vince, that neither Hart made mention of the fact that they will both be in the Royal Rumble match? They could wind up facing each other whether they like it or not.
Yes, they could. The Hart brothers are two of the 30 individuals in the over-the-top rope. Every man for himself. Royal Rumble. The Rocket Owen Hart to the outside. And the Hitman's brother, although he is the, I should say, the brother. No, well, how does Owen want to have that phrase now? That the Hitman is his brother. Drop kick from the top. Doesn't matter, they're brothers one way or another. And Barry Hardy is just about ready to see something known as the sharpshooter. Who applies the sharpshooter better, Owen or his brother Brett? It is just as effective one way or another. Yeah, Brett knows exactly how painful that hold is. And without exception, anyone who has been placed in the sharpshooter automatically gives up. And there you see it, ladies and gentlemen. It was a great Christmas present last week. The Rocket and the Hitman, they are back together, having resolved their differences. They are on their way to the Royal Rumble. They are perhaps on their way to becoming tag team champions. Look at that. Hoo-wah! And the Rocket flying high this week. And there you see the Hitman, Bret Hart, and the Rocket, Owen Hart, as the Rocket takes a look at himself and the Hitman. There with the Rocket.
Well, Stu and Helen have to be proud now. Look at that. That's a good sight.
No question. We'll see him at the Royal Rumble, folks. Standing by, we're going to take you to a Royal Rumble report shortly. Todd Pettengill is going to let us in on just who has been added to the Royal Rumble matchup itself when we return.
Ring announcer, Chris McKenna.
How about that?
Did he say honorary?
Yes. Chris McKenna.
Introducing first, accompanied by his brother Owen Hart, from Calgary, Alberta, Canada, weighing 234 pounds, Brett Hart.
How about that?
That kid fired me up. He's good.
What a ring announcer this young man makes here. Our weekly guest ring announcer, and Chris McKenna did an outstanding job. Move over Bill Dunn, move over Howard Finkel.
You know, now that you mention Howard Finkel, if Chris McKenna went down to a dime store and purchased one of those little 10-cent mustaches, and if he lost most of his hair and he had a lot kind of facial twitch, he'd be perfect for that job.
I don't know about that. He made a very good ring announcer. And the Hart brothers, Owen and Brett, making a lot of fans about ringside very, very happy. And the Hitman, Bret Hart, ready to lock up with Mike Bell. Words of encouragement from brother Owen.
Yes, Owen's right there ringside. They're back together again. It's a great sight. The holiday season obviously brought the Hart family closer together. But I tell you what, I heard that Brett got more presents.
Stop it now. Please, there's no reason for you to be a source of all that as well. They are back together, Owen and Brett, vying for the tag team championship at the Royal Rumble. Although there is one interesting factor, Stan, that you and I were talking about before the broadcast this week, that you don't hear. Oh my goodness, wait a minute, stay with this. Bell with a clothesline, but he's not following through. You have to stay right on top of Brett if in fact you have any hopes of defeating the former WWF champion.
Well,
we're stating
Brett
before that in essence, we've heard a lot of commentary as it relates to their collective tag team effort, but no commentary from either man as it relates to their individual effort to win the actual Royal Rumble matchup itself. They are in both the tag title matchup and the Royal Rumble matchup as well. We have pre-recorded comments now from the Hart brothers. Let's listen in and hear what they have to say.
I can't tell you how happy I am to have an opportunity to be tagging with you, Brett, at the Royal Rumble, and we're going for those tag team belts. Let's make this one a best one yet.
This is gonna be the big day for the Hart brothers. Quebecers, you're going down in the Royal Rumble, and you're gonna go down hard. You're looking at the next WWF tag team champion.
Well, again, Stan, there's no reference made to the fact that they could be facing each other, every man for himself, in the actual Royal Rumble match.
Well, they can deny it all they want. They can try to avoid talking about it, but like you said, it may come down to that. They may have to face each other, in fact, in the Royal Rumble.
The crowd anxiously awaiting the Hitman, Bret Hart, to put the sharpshooter on Mike Bell. He steps on the wraps the leg over, and yes, gets it in. Tremendous victory for the Hitman, Bret Hart. And here comes Brother Owen.
Well, he was fired up at ringside, wasn't he? He loved it.
Yeah.
Look at there.
These two, what a beautiful sight it is to see them back together. Owen and Brett, the brothers headed to the Royal Rumble to perhaps become tag team champions. Speaking of whom, they are scheduled for a special interview momentarily, and they're also headed this Monday night in what they are likely to call a tune-up match to face the 1-2-3 Kid and the Kid's partner, Marty Jannetty.
There's no denying the fact that the Hart brothers were trained by a master, Stu Hart, and it's obvious by these perfectly executed maneuvers.
Yes, indeed. The Harts, Owen and Brett, headed to the Royal Rumble. Take a look here, Owen. Bring him back. Come take a look at what we have seen Owen and Brett do so many times. The sharpshooter applied, they both are the excellence of execution. Will they be tag team champions? That will be answered at the Royal Rumble, and we'll have the champions with us momentarily. Stay with us, everyone.
Are accompanied by their manager, Johnny Polo. They are the reigning WWF Tag Team Champions, Jacques and Pierre, the Quebecers.
And yes, the Quebecers, as we stated before, headed this Monday night to Monday Night Raw, defending the Tag Team Championship on the one-year anniversary show against Marty Jannetty and the 1-2-3 Kid.
Understand there's going to be a big party, and I love parties. You going to be there?
Oh, yeah.
It seems that you have had your problems as of late with one Lex Luger.
I hate Lex Luger. He's a yellow-bellied coward. First of all, he sticks a piece of metal in his elbow so he can be like the Bionic Man or something. Then he has a match with Pierre, knocks him out. Then he has a match with Jacques, knocks him out. Knocks Pierre out again, then he knocks me out. I'll tell you what, Lex Luger, come Royal Rumble, I hope you're left all alone in the ring with 10 of our friends, and you'll find out you're not such a knockout after all.
All right, gentlemen, in 2 weeks, these coveted WWF Tag Team belts will be on the line against the brother team of Owen and Bret Hart.
Let's move to the question, oh. Royal Rumble, who won't be Bret Hart over the cross either?
Now, wait a minute. Couldn't you extend us a little courtesy and speak some English?
Hey, we don't care about English. We don't care about Americans. Let me tell you one thing. There is no one in the World Wrestling Federation that is close like Pierre and I. We share everything. And I'll tell you something else, too. Brothers are not always close. And I'll tell you something else. And brothers don't always get along.
Give me the microphone, right? Let me tell you something. To prove what kind of champions we are, this Monday night on Raw, we will be defending the belts against Marty Jannetty and the 1-2-3 Kid, who are much worthier opponents than those stupid Hart brothers.
And I'll tell you what, too. We're going to show the world that we are not closet champions. We are fighting champions. And come, after we take care of those two, come Royal Rumble, we're going to show you what brotherly love is all about.
We have heard from the Quebecers. They're on their way to the Royal Rumble to face the Hitman and the Rocket. And this Monday night, who knows?
Last week on Monday Night Raw, Marty Jannetty and the poster boy for Pampers thought they backed me into a corner. Suckers! My Quebecer machine is gonna squish you like a bunch of cockroaches.
That's right, you're just a tune-up match. War minds are already set up on the Royal Rumble. Owen and Bret Hart, we're gonna show the world what brotherly love is all about.
What's he doing? He is not going for the cover. This is the second time one of the Quebecers. And here it goes. We've seen this before, ladies and gentlemen. All the way from the top rope, here comes Pierre. Oh, no! My goodness.
Squashed him.
The 1-2-3 Kid giving it his all along with Marty Jannetty. And again, though, well, now look what they're doing, Randy Savage. They're not even trying to cover the kid. They're trying to punish him They're trying to make an example of the kid. And Marty Jannetty, knowing that the Hart brothers are watching this broadcast, knowing that the Royal Rumble is only 12 days away, don't tell me they're going to do it again. The official tonight, where Marty Jannetty coming out? Could have disqualified Jannetty right there. He did not.
The Quebecers are trying to send a message to the Hart brothers, but Jannetty got involved, and I'm damn glad he did.
Marty Jannetty has a work in the 1-2-3 kick. Can he make the tag? Can he? Yes, he got a kick out, Marty Jannetty. Jannetty has a hot spot. Marty Jannetty missing with most of that last drop kick, and now slamming Pierre Jannetty. Setting up shot, coming off the rope, elbow to the sternum. Who's the legal Quebecer in there? I'm not so sure I can recall.
Hit them both.
Oh, knocker, knocker.
Johnny Polo.
Johnny Polo was just nailed.
Wait a minute, look at this.
1-2-3 kick going up. As we speak, and you can bet the Quebecers are, hello, gentlemen, Quebecers, along with Johnny Polo, you don't look too happy.
Oh, man, it stinks. I mean, I can't believe we got beat by a bunch of losers like that. I mean, right. They pulled the tights, they had a handful of hair.
It's all right, Johnny, it's all right. You know why it's all right, McMahon?
No, I have no idea why it's all
right. I'm gonna tell you why, because we got a genius as a manager. You signed a rematch for us, Johnny.
Yeah,
you did. Yeah. In case those two little punies would fluke on us. Let me tell you something, Johnny. We're gonna go get those boys in Madison Square Gardens, the contract that you signed for us, and we're going to the Royal Rumble to beat the Hearts with our titles, McMahon.
Yeah, yeah. Well, I signed the contract Monday night next Monday, Madison Square Garden. We're gonna take those boys back, and we're going to the Royal Rumble.
How about that, McMahon?
All right, well, thank you very much for joining us, the Quebecers, along with Johnny Polo, ladies and gentlemen.
Sour grapes.
They have big plans for next Monday. We've got plans.
From the pages of the WWF magazine, here's Update.
Hello, everyone. I'm Gorilla Monsoon for Update. Well, folks, here we are just about a week away from the big one, the blockbuster, the 1994 Royal Rumble at the sold-out Providence Civic Center, and the tag team situation has just exploded. This past Monday night on Monday Night Raw, Quebecers dropped the coveted WWF tag team titles to the 1-2-3 Kid and Marty Jannetty. How about that? Not a shock to me. I knew all along that Marty Jannetty and the 1-2-3 Kid had tremendous capabilities, and they proved it on Monday Night Raw. What does this do now to the Royal Rumble? That means that the coveted WWF tag team belts are not up for grabs. The only titles now not at stake at the Royal Rumble. Obviously, the Hearts, Brett and Owen, got to be very disturbed about this. Perhaps mixed emotions. Let's find out. We have the Hearts standing by.
The first thing I want to do is congratulate the 1-2-3 Kid and Marty Jannetty on beating the Quebecers for the World Wrestling Federation tag team belts.
Yeah, well, that's just great. You know, I just can't believe it, Brett. Every time we get our big break, my big break, something like this has got to happen.
Don't even worry about it, because I know that the 1-2-3 Kid and Marty Jannetty are jam up, and they'll be the first ones to give us a title shot, especially after we beat the Quebecers in the Royal Rumble. You know, I want to make a big announcement. I'm really happy to say this. For the time being, actually for the rest of my career, I am going to dedicate myself to strictly tag team wrestling. All my singular matches are going to be done. All my contract obligations will be completed. But after that, I'm sticking into tags with you, Owen, and it's going to be my promise to my family, to you, and myself, that we will win the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team belts, and we're going to do it for each other.
Maybe we'll get a chance.
Well, there you have it, folks. You got to feel a little bit sorry for the Rocket, Owen Hart. This was his big opportunity, his chance to make a place for himself here in the World Wrestling Federation and do something that he has never done before, that's put some gold around his waist. But how about that announcement from Bret the Hitman, that after he finishes all his contractual obligations, he's going to devote his entire career to making sure that he and his brother Owen one day get their hands on the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team belts. What an electrifying person. What a big heart must beat inside the body of the Hitman. Well, Johnny Polo, a lot of people think he's a dummy. He proved himself to be pretty smart, sticking that clause in the contract that whomever defeated the Quebecers would have to give them a return match within 10 days. Well, it's not going to take 10 days. It's going to take a lot shorter than that, because this coming Monday night in Madison Square Garden, there will be a return match, and the 1-2-3 Kid and Marty Jannetty will have to defend their newly acquired titles against the former champions, the Quebecers. We've got comments from all these individuals coming up right now.
Last Monday night, Marty Jannetty, 1-2-3 Kid, you pulled the upset of the century. I can't believe it. It was a fluke. We weren't ready. I don't know what happened, but I'll tell you what. I made sure there was a clause in the contract that we would get a return match just in case. This Monday night, Madison Square Garden, the return match.
That's right. This Monday night, 1-2-3 Kid, Marty Jannetty, we vow we'll get our titles back. Because we're going next week to Royal Rumble to defend our titles for you, the Hearts. You be ready!
Ah! New tag team champions. What about that? You Quebecers aren't laughing so much now, are you? You know, last time you took us a little bit light, you said that we didn't have a chance in the world. You just didn't care, did you? Well, what does it feel like now? I tell you what, this coming Monday night, though, you get one more chance to prove that this was a fluke, like you're saying. If you don't get it done, tuck those tails and head back to Canada. Tell them, kid.
That's right, Quebecers. And at Madison Square Garden, we'll just see if it was a fluke. We're going to defend these belts against you guys, and hopefully we'll keep them.
No, not hopefully. We will.
Well, there you have it, folks. Obviously, the 1-2-3 Kid and Marty Jannetty very confident about this match coming up in Madison Square Garden. Their first title defense. But on the other hand, Quebecers, along with their manager, very shrewd and possibly capable of once again getting that gold back around their waist. Well, the ramifications of that are just enormous, because if the Quebecers win, that means that at the Royal Rumble, Hearts will get their chance to become the WWF Tag Team Champions. Who will the Hitman and Owen be cheering for in Madison Square Garden? Will it be the 1-2-3 Kid and Marty Jannetty, or the Quebecers? What is more important to them?
Last week, a record-setting national television audience enjoyed Monday Night Raw, enjoyed watching those two youngsters claim the WWF Tag Team title. With that in mind, we have Stan Lane from Madison Square Garden. Stan, what's going on?
Yes, I can hear you, Vince. Thank you, question. But there's electricity in the air here at the Garden. I was just back in the individual dressing rooms of both teams. They're warming up. Negotiating. The professionals are very confident in the 1-2-3 Kid and Marty Jannetty have fire in their eyes.
As they did here last week, and if you would, keep us informed as things develop from Madison Square Garden.
I certainly will.
Stan Lane reporting.
Vince, those guys can have all the fire in the eyes that they want brought out. The Quebecers are going to prove to everybody that that title change was nothing but a fluke. I guarantee it.
Oh, really? All right, Austin now. Whip to the buckle, and oh, my goodness, what a back body drop.
Very nice execution. I tell you what, Owen Hart has never looked better, Vince. I never really cared for this guy, but I got to give credit where credit's due. He's looking sharp. He's looking good. He's looking confident.
Wow, look at that. The Rocket. Some feel as though he's been living in the shadow of his brother.
Definitely.
But then again, Owen has had an opportunity to prove his own individual merit.
He stays on his opponent, keeps him down. I tell you what, he can finish this guy anytime he wants to. Look at that.
Standing drop kick, nicely done.
Right on the button, brother, right on the chin. Just where you want to land.
Owen Hart at one time was so frustrated with living in the shadow of his brother, he challenged Bret Hart. He challenged Bret Hart to a one-on-one encounter. We're happy to say they have reconciled their differences, and now they're a tag team going into the Royal Rumble from the top rope. What a drop kick.
Nice job, nice drop kick.
However, at the actual Royal Rumble, the Royal Rumble matchup as well, they may be opponents, because as you said before, it's every man for himself.
Look at this. It's the sharpshooter, Vince. Check
the
it out, buddy.
Sharpshooter coming at you.
I think he does it better than Brett. I'm not sure. Look at that. Perfectly executed.
But there is the excellence of execution.
Now, Vince, you tell me Brett doesn't look jealous, brother.
In no way, not a jealous bone in his body. The Hitman, Bret Hart, unquestionably very proud of accomplishments of Owen. I'm going to get a word with him.
Owen Hart looks very impressive tonight. I got to admit, brother. But Bret and Owen, stay out of my way in the Royal Rumble.
Congratulations, another victory for the Rocket. Owen Hart on his way to the Royal Rumble along with his brother, the Hitman, Bret Hart. And this could very well be the Royal Rumble, your moment, the tag team championship up for grabs. But is it? Because tonight, well, the rematch is going to take place in Madison Square Garden momentarily. And I wonder if we get your comments, Owen, as to whom you believe you would like to see victorious. Would you like to see the 1-2-3 Kid and Marty Jannetty victorious? Or would you like to see the Quebecers take it back?
Well, you know, Vince, that's really great for the 1-2-3 Kid and Marty Jannetty. They're getting a shot at the WWF belts. I don't want to take anything away from those guys, but this was an opportunity for me and also Brett too. But now it's been kind of taken away, so I don't want to say anything against 1-2-3 Kid and Marty Jannetty, but I'm kind of looking forward to fighting the Quebecers, and I kind of hope that they're the tag team champions so that Brett and I can get an opportunity to fight for the WWF tag team belts.
Brett, your comment.
As far as I'm concerned, Marty Jannetty and the 1-2-3 Kid, they make great champions. And under no circumstances would I ever find myself cheering for the Quebecers, no matter what happens. Let the chips fall where they may. But the 1-2-3, Marty Jannetty, I'm sure they'd give us a title shot when the time's right.
Well, the best of luck to both of you, title or no title. Thank you very much for joining us. Brett Rush in the 30-man, every man for himself, Royal Rumble, as is Diesel, as is Sean, as are the Steiner brothers, who are brother against brother in that. Owen and Brett, they may go at it as well. Speaking of the Hearts, or actually speaking of the tag team championship, let's go back to Madison Square Garden, Stan Lane. With recent developments, Stan, are you there?
Gentlemen, the crowd is heartbroken. They can't believe what happened, and I can't believe what Johnny Polo got away with. 1-2-3 and Marty were robbed.
I told you, Vince.
The crowd is very upset and disconsolate.
Well, that's bad news. We thank you for your report, but I guess it's good news for Owen and Brett to a certain extent that now the matchup that the Hearts will have against the Quebecers this Saturday night, as the Hearts prepare to do double duty, will be for the title.
Wait a minute, Vince. I didn't hear one congratulation for the Quebecers, but they deserve it. They work hard for those belts. Come on, give them a congratulations right now.
Well, congratulations to Monday Night Raw last week, first anniversary. Record.
From the pages of the WWF magazine, here's Update.
Hello, everyone. I'm Gorilla Monsoon for Update, brought to you this week by the WWF merchandise catalog featuring that hot item, the Royal Rumble T-shirts. And don't forget, all these catalogs are available in all WWF publications. Well, folks, the unthinkable has happened. Due to a contractual agreement stuck in there by manager Johnny Polo, the Quebecers got an opportunity this past Monday night to get their belts back at Madison Square Garden from the 1-2-3 Kid and Marty Jannetty, and they did just that. Well, the ramifications of that? At the 1994 WWF Royal Rumble, Bret the Hitman Hart and brother Owen get an opportunity to become WWF Tag Team Champions. Quebecers are standing by right now, folks. They have to be elated.
Just like we promised, we said we were going to win the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team titles back, and we did it. Marty Jannetty, 1-2-3 Kid, thanks for shining the belts for us. Now tonight, Royal Rumble, Hart Brothers, we didn't lose the belts and regain them just to lose them to you two geeks. We're going to keep the belts tonight at Royal Rumble, and we hope you two beat the snot out of each other.
Let me tell you something, ladies and gentlemen. Tonight, when we're going to defend our title against the Hearts, where we're going to show you what really brotherly love is all about.
Well, folks, there you have it. They are elated indeed, the Quebecers, but maybe a little bit overconfident because, in my opinion, Bret the Hitman Hart and Brother Owen present a much formidable team than the 1-2-3 Kid and Marty Jannetty did, and they are in jeopardy of once again, in a very short period of time, losing the coveted WWF Tag Team Championship belts. Later on in the program, we're going to have a special interview with Bret the Hitman and Brother Owen. And also, don't forget, folks, it is tonight at the sold-out Providence Civic Center, the WWF Royal Rumble. The only way for you to be part of it now, pick up that telephone, call your local cable company, and say, I want to be part of this extravaganza.
Ladies and gentlemen, when my next guest step out of the ring at tonight's WWF Royal Rumble, perhaps they will be the new World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions. Let's welcome Bret and Owen, the Hart Brothers.
Yes, what a tremendous opportunity for the Hart Brothers. However, let's listen in to Ray Rougeau in the interview. Let's see if he's going to ask him about the Royal Rumble matchup. Let's see if he's going to ask him about the fact that they will be competing with each other, notwithstanding their collective effort.
Owen, a lot of things have happened. A lot of things have been said that, frankly, have been quite divisive. Now, they have hurt the fans. They have obviously hurt your family. Well, I'm sure they have hurt both of you, but how are things right now? I mean, tonight's a big match.
Ray, honestly, I want you to listen and listen good. Everything is okay between me and Bret. Everything is great. Things haven't been better between Bret and I. Tonight is gonna be our night. And I just want you to picture this. Five different times, I watched my brother Bret come home, and he brought a different WWF belt home, and he laid it on that dining room table. And Mom and Dad, they watched, and it was a sight to see. God, it made us all so proud. Well, tonight, Mom, tonight, Dad, this is gonna be my night with Bret, because we're going for those WWF belts, and this is gonna prove to everybody that it really can happen. I'm finally gonna get my big break. I'm finally gonna get my chance, and it's gonna be great. The Rocket is gonna be blasting off higher than he's ever gone before, and the Hitman, he's gonna be right on top of that Rocket. And you know where we're going? Straight to the top. The Quebecers, you guys are going down. The Rocket and the Hitman, we're gonna be number one.
All right. You know, Bret, at the risk of sounding redundant, I mean, the things have obviously been said. There has to be scar tissue. How do you feel about this?
Well, if you're asking me whether it hurt the little altercation that I had with my brother, it's like he said, it's water under the bridge. It is over and done with, and it doesn't matter anymore because we are a unit. We are two brothers going to the very top. And tonight in the Royal Rumble, you're gonna find out that the Hart Brothers are the greatest team combined together in the history of the World Wrestling Federation. And as far as the Quebecers go, tonight, when you lose against the Hart Brothers, I want you to know one thing, that we're winning these championship belts, the World Wrestling Federation championship belts. We are gonna win them for ourselves. We are gonna win them for our family. But most of all, we are gonna win for you fans out there. This is it. It's showtime in the Royal Rumble. And the Hart Brothers, there is no stopping us now.
All right.